My presentation is the last presentation of the MAM. I'll do it quickly. I hoped all of you are here for my presentation, not for the lottery, but maybe I has a wrong presentation. Then I'll do it quickly. I intend to do more deeper the presentation, but the last will be very light. Okay? If you want can something, I give you an email and we can touch in contact later to do more profound questions. This is mine. My name is Jorge Castellet, George Little Castle, for people who know it in Spain, a literal translation. I am a certified trainer. I have certifications. I have something on experience on the working and wireless ICP providers. Okay, then start quick. One moment. We have a problem, Houston. Our customer calls to call centers telling to us that they don't have internet in their home. Okay, if I speak too quickly in English, it's not my mother language, you can tell that, and I try to speak more slow. Maybe not change anything my pronunciation, but I try to do better, okay? Then. After some check-ins, your customer calls to you, you determine that you verify that your customer has reset the router and it's not have internet, but that question you told to him and they say he's not touching nothing. He was sleeping and the router was in another room and magically they was without internet, okay? Then you have to go to your customer home to solve the problem. This is a big problem for you because it's winter, there are 2 meters of snow in the road, okay? And you have to go to there. Maybe 1,000 kilometers ago from your headquarters, okay? Then then you think it will be wonderful if my devices will be auto-configuration, magically or not, but they can auto-configure itself, okay? Only by plugging to the power and they will be configured. It will be more free time for me to improve my business or do another thing I want. Okay, yep, it's too quick. Then my wish list will be, I need a system with what my devices can communicate with him, is it needs to be able to identify my devices and send personalization configurations to the devices of the CPE. And also able to me if the device is configured or not, and in which situation is that device is connected to me. Then the magician or disappears if a training in the wish granted, okay, you have CPE1 management protocol, CWMP, or auto-configuration server, ACS. In the time I started the presentation, maybe I have not that color of the hair in my head, or maybe yes, because I don't remember when I start. MikroT don't have support to tier 069, okay? Then I make my own protocol. What is CWMP? CWMP is a technical report 69. It's a technical specification that defines the application layer for remote management of CPE and connected to an IP network. Okay, they only need to a connection to our network to configure the device. It's a standard that has been open. One moment. Here running from Spain, I have also hung. Okay, continues. The standard was developed for automatic configuration and management of devices from an auto-configuration server. Okay. It is defined by Broadband Forum. It was first published on 204, okay? There will be another papers comes to write in 206, 207, 210, 211. Is the last, I think is the last. 214, yeah. Then, it's based on sub-TTP-based protocol, includes safe configuration, control management functions, and an integrated framework. That protocol is based on a session where all the messages are exchanged during a conversation between the server and the client, okay? Only a client, or CPE, can initiate that conversation. Server always expecting the connection from a client. Also, the server can tell to the client to initiate a conversation to him, okay? But directly they can send commands to the client. Then, for example, will be first boot, reboot, predical interval, okay? Transfer is complete, diagnosis completed, you change any parameters of the client, they send you a communication, a session to the server to inform that the change. Okay, a second request. And, okay, let's just do it. The parameters of configuration are simple, are XML, are a name and a value pairs, okay? Each vendor needs to support their data model in their devices, okay? Yeah, the data model from a vendor is a combination of supported parameters. There are three root data models, TR98, TR181, version 1 and 2. MikroTik is supporting 181, I remember, yeah. Then, what about security? That protocol can run over internet. You have a customer over internet link, you can contact to you. Then will be a problem because internet is a very dangerous network, okay? All the bad people are in that network. Then you need to authenticate with a username and password. You can also use a CCL client certificate to beta do a configuration. And as you see, when you use a security protocol to communicate with the server. Okay. We also can implement other security in my device, like maybe a source address list or destination address list to only permit that the configuration server to contact to us to send a request to initiate a session, only to communicate with that IP and not to another IP. Okay. Then, this is all from the standard. I'm going to do my own system. My own system is not based on the standard, it's ideas from the standard that commands are not the same, that will be easily translated to the XML standard. Okay, we need two parts: client part, the upper part, and the server part. We need to survive to the customer or user, and we need to schedule events to the server. The server needs to receive device information, display data the client has sent to him, and adoption a new device, okay, to insert into the system. We need that our device executes a script when it restarts. Yes, this is easy. We schedule an event and it's good. Good beer. Then, but if the client performs a device reset, you know by MikroTik that the configuration is missing and nothing works. Then we need our Volubility tool that is netinstall to solve that problem. Overwriting the default startup script to add our management configuration. Well, then we need to read the default startup script to do the initial contact with the server, indicating that it's a new device, install the script and schedule it for ping the server to receive information. That script will do keep alive or heartbeat, receive config script, initial, and install and send the device's status whenever it needs. Okay. I do, because it's for prototyping, I use that system. It's not necessarily do it by that. I don't explain how install that components. Maybe it's outside of that course. It's something needs to learn more about. I can send information about that. Okay. Then, in the server, we have in the part of the CPE for that four scripts. That's one. No kick like that. The knock script is called initially by the client when it's a first boot or make a reboot. It's the part that will be override the default script of the MikroT client. Okay, this only is called with that in that place. It also is called periodically until we adopt the device. Then that script is disabled and another script starts again. Okay, it has responses wait that is in the system, is waiting for me to accept the device. It has to send a command to the client, and it has nothing to do because there's no command pending to send to him. The keep alive script is the next script. It's similar to knock, but only is doing a knocking the server to wait for a command to execute in the client. Okay. It's more simple, that only executes a microtip scripting. Okay. Server will be an script and send to the client. The client execute the script. The function is easy. Now there is the device, as you know, is not an error. It's not in the system. Knock is in adoption process. It's not suitable to do a keep alive process. RPC to doing a command and nothing is not hub command pending in the queue. Data PHP. This script is called by the client when it wants to receive the script that is pending for him. Okay, they call that script and they download the script and execute in the client. They only microt client commands. Okay, it's not ERPC is the script that is called by the CPE when they finish. The script, the execution, and enforced with a status. Okay, script has no error. It has will be executed in my customer devices. An error, there an error, maybe it's a syntax error that I write typing the script in the server, or maybe it's, I put an interface in Noxist or something like that. No problem. Okay, server have. Three steps you have to do. You need to adopt the device, you have to view the information, and we need to change the device configuration we decided. Okay. In the part of Discover, there is a web page. You can see it is a very modern interface. Okay. That interface. In the first step, you start up the client. They showing us that it's a first boot, it's making our MAC address, the platform router bar, it's a virtual machine, and the router's version, its status is pending for accepting for me. When I click the adopt button, it asks me to name the device, to set the identity, and the device is marked for adopting state, okay? And the next execution of knock script, the client will be know that it's in that state and will be download the keep alive script and they will go to manage devices. Okay, here. El 11 will be periodic because it's a periodic event in that case. Okay, we can send commands to him and change parameters we need in that. Then, in the MikroTik, in the CPE, we need a script that performs queries to the server to do that job. Uh, We need to customize the default script of MakerTik to survive the reset of its boot, okay? The test script will be the same until we adopt the device, okay? We use three scripts. Knock is the initial script. Keep alive is once the device has been adopted, and run keep alive is checking for a new version of keep alive, making the substitution and execute the new version of keep alive, because maybe I want to change the structure of the, or maybe I can add the new command to do on the client. They need to change the script of the client, okay? You also use functions, client functions from other people. I use urn code from Scott. This is the forum where I found years ago that script, git between from Curious Kiwi. That's the forum, you can check here. Okay, this is a part of Knock script. It's doing with old version of router OS. You know that you can send post data in a HashOnS form, okay? It will be more secure because it's not in the URL of the call to the server, but because when I start was a very old version, it has in 5.24, I think, then it's maintained this version, okay? Then get the script is checking it have to execute it a command, and execute the command, commits knock start adoption, they download the script and execute the script. And also disable the old scheduling and initiate the new scheduling of the script. It's, all the job is do it here, and the script is in that line, and keep alive. And so, okay, and keep alive is a smaller version of the other. The only check is they have to run a script, and after check is a script to run, they execute here and inform the result to the server. But I finish that question, and I show that MakerTik have theory. Oh, 6.9, I do a job very good, I think, for me, okay, it's working, but it's more suitable to use that. I'm too fast speaking, you want to finish before to start the raffle before, or is a good speed speaking from me? Yeah, okay, good. Then, we have a TRSL 6.9 client, then have to use. It's a very reduced version of the presentation, okay? At the end of the presentation, there are a slide of links you can read from the documentation, and another presentation from, I think it's Zambia last year, from TR6NIT on MikroTik. It will be more visual like mine, and you can also know a lot of things here. Okay. RouterOS implements support for HTTP or HTTPS on URL of autoconfiguration server, okay? We can specify a username and password for authentication and to log into the app system. You have periodic inform. We have a client certificate to extra to do, give an extra security. That a model that we are using is TRI 108.1, used to, okay? It will be the screen of the client. We fill the parameters. You can see that some are optional. You don't specify a username and password. You have to insert to the instruct to the configuration server that they will be maybe use the MAC address, like username or like that one, because you don't have authentication to the server. Okay, but after reset, the configuration also are lost. We still need to override the file configuration to insert the tier 069 configuration to contact our server and configure an IP address or internet connection that the client can reach the IP address of the auto configuration server. Okay? there is a sample script, only the part of TR69, not the rest of the configuration in the wiki of MikroTik. Like you need to put that part, that script in your default configuration. Okay, script. Then MikroTik is compatible with that systems. First are not open source, and the last one an open source that is that one I use here. Okay, I try to use. This was there are a lot of open source, but are not maintained. That is a problem. You can use that one. It's a little difficult to install, I think. But Gini Authorization Server is a fast, lightweight system. It's an open source with advanced device post-processing capabilities. Is using Node.js, I think, it's, and MongoDB database for store the information. I could the presentation. We install all the configuration. We can review one passage later. But there is a tricky. When we start, we are happy. We install our server after 23 hours of downloading Node.js problems, compiling our Linux version is not correct, and so on, and so on, and so on. And configure our client, and this will be appears. Maybe you think I'm going to sleep, and when I get up, it will be all fine. It's not possible. This is what happens when you start a MikroTik device in that system. It's not doing nothing. Because by default, Gini ICS is prepared to clients of the other version, the TR098, not for the last version that used MikroTik. Then we have two options. One is changing that files. Okay, you can see that MikroTik is missing internet gateway device. Okay, we can change that files to adapt that version. Then only will be suitable for clients with the last version, la 181. Is not will be accepting clients because in the old clients will be a error like that. Okay, but it's a problem because we need to do these changes for all parameters, wireless, routing, everything. Okay, this is really for the basic to appear in the initial page. The West Bay is to use functions that will be return the value depend of the kind of client that is contacted to the server. Okay, will be used. Use virtual parameters. They are user-defined parameters. You define the function in scripting in JavaScript, and then I will be checked is a MikroTik device or maybe another kind of device. Here, all of you only use MikroTik devices. There's really easy to do that function. You don't need too much scripting, and use a custom values to fill the information of the screen here and the others. That these virtual parameters are input and output. You can put and get values from that, okay? And I think I go too fast. You have here more information about the presentation, okay? This is a presentation I was telling you before from the Zambia. The website of the site, and I think I finished my presentation. Some question. The lottery comes here now. Or about that, you can want to see code or something like that, or I can dance. I don't know nothing about dancing. I can do performance here.
Maybe so do we have Jasper? Any questions? Or is everybody waiting for the lottery?
Yeah.
Thank you, Jorge.
Thank you, thank you.
Okay, thank you. So then.